waited before a different judge. Meanwhile, the lovers will remain remanded until the 24th of October, when Jackie's bid to be released on bond will be heard. Francis Ontomwa, KTN News, Nairobi.
Central Organization of Trade Union COTU Secretary General Francis Atwoli and Devolution Cabinet Secretary Eugene Wamalwa have today paid a courtesy call to former President Daniel Arap Moi at his Kabarak home in Nakuru County. The meeting majorly focused on national unity and the state of the nation. Murimi Mwangi reports.
Amani.
A week after the reinstated October 10th Moi Day holiday, Central Organization of Kenya Trade Union Secretary General Francis Atwoli, accompanied by Devolution Cabinet Secretary Eugene Wamalwa, paid a courtesy call on retired President Daniel Arap Moi at his Kabarak home.
It was very great, particularly after Moi Day, to come and pay a courtesy call on Mzee on behalf of Kenyan workers that he supported. And he still supports workers of this country.
Atwoli, Wamalwa, and COTU First Vice Chairperson Reverend Joel Chebi are the latest Kabarak visitors. Others who have in recent days paid courtesy calls on Moi being Mombasa Governor Hassan Ali Joho, who led a delegation of coastal leaders there in late August, and opposition chief Raila Odinga, who visited the former president in April before President Uhuru Kenyatta's Kabarak courtesy call in July.
Something amazing that Mzee still remembers everything that goes on and is up to date with any information, be it political, social, that is taking place.
He's asked me whether we have paid the farmers and completed the payment, and I've assured him that we have made very good progress in paying the farmers over the last 1 or 2 weeks.
But while the Atwoli Wamalwa one-hour closed-door meeting with Moi was said to brainstorm on efforts of peace-building, the routine Kabarak visits by key leaders have not been without political undertones, particularly coming after the March 9th Odinga cooperation deal with President Kenyatta. Atwoli has been among the fiercest campaigners for constitutional changes to create a powerful executive post to accommodate Kenyatta's stay in office past his two maximum terms as president. His deputy William Ruto, a key protagonist in the 2022 presidential race, was unable to meet the retired president in May, who was at the time said to be under treatment when Ruto made a trip to Kabarak. Analysts argue the Kabarak visits could be part of backroom deals, culminating in a political alliance, housing or deal.